You beat the percussion section to help us out. They got it, right?
One.
He lived a few blocks from me, sang a few songs, and I made the audition, and that's where the Tokens were born, in Brooklyn, New York. The kid's name was Neil Sedaka, by the way.
Had any hits?
He had some hits after us, he did. You know, we wrote a lot of our own songs, and we get a lot of requests to do the B-side of Tonight I Fell in Love. The B-side of the record, of course, our kids and our grandchildren have no idea what we mean when we say the B-side of a record. They have no idea what a record is. But we knew the B-sides of the records, didn't we? We knew the color of the labels. Right? We even knew the way the writing was on the labels. But you know, those days are gone, but the music is still here, and this one is called I'll Always Love You.
Ah.
heard of it.
Now living in Boynton Beach, Florida. Became a snowstorm or a snow, whatever you call it.
Smart.
One of those. Smart. Sang in a lot of big hit records as a vocalist in the background. Made those records number one. Remember Pretty Little Angel Eyes by Curtis Lee? Remember that one? Remember a record by Barry Mann called Who Put the Bomb in the Bunker? Well, you know, the guys on the background, they never get any credit, so I'm giving him credit right now. Say hi to Bill Reed, everybody. Thank you. And he put the man in the red. The man in the red coat, originally also from Brooklyn, New York. When he was a kid in Brooklyn, he was part of a group that had a big number one record. The name of the record was Hushabye. Remember that by the group called the Mystics? Well, he was a little mystic when he was a little mystic. You know, that group broke up after a few years, and he took the train all the way from Brooklyn, New York to a place called Far Rockaway in Queens, New York. Now, when he got to Far Rockaway, he met three other guys, and they formed a brand new group. And these three guys, they call themselves the Americans. This is Jay Traynor, the original Jay of Jay and the Americans. He was the guy that made their first million-selling record, number one record, and the name of that record was She Cried. Now, if it weren't for that record of She Cried that soared up the charts, I don't know what would have... It was your fault that they became such big stars after that. It was your fault. She Cried made them that way.
I'm really sorry about that.
Who are you?
Yes.
Yeah, I don't know. You want to hear She Cried by the original Jay? Mr. Jay Traynor.
Voices. This fella right here has one of the silkiest, smooth voices
God ever put in a body. Really. We've been singing a few decades together, and he sounds just like he did in 1961, don't you think? I mean, really. It's just voices, no tricks, and great musicians back here. Besides doing the lead vocal on all the Tolkien's recordings, Jay produced a lot of number one hit songs. For Tony Orlando and Dawn, Jay produced and sang on the song Candida, Knock Three Times, and Tie a Little Ribbon.
Three gigantic hits.
Three good ones. For The Happenings, Jay produced a song called See You in September, Go Away Little Girl, and a great version of an old standard called I Got a Rhythm, and I Do. And for The Chiffons, The Bronx, Jay produced their first and second number one hit songs. 1963 was He's So Fine, and the 63 was One Fine Day. They're still working today. The song's held up. In 1963, for Glory Records, Jay produced a song for Randy and the Rainbows that went all the way to number one, called Oh Denise, from Queens, New York. He's originally from Brooklyn, like he said. The other Jay and I went south, he went north. He lives about 40 miles north of New York City in a place called Spring Valley. And tomorrow's his birthday, so pick a pillow up. And he is still older than I am.
I love it.
I'll always be old. I love it. Yes, you will. Would you warmly welcome Jay Siegel.
Thank you very much.
That's Happy birthday, Jay.
Thank you very much. We've been on the road. We do this. I mean, this is our job. We do this all year round. You guys are like, can we take you with us? You're the best audience we've ever heard.
Get in the bus.
You're having a better time than we
are. We're not just saying it. You are unbelievable.
You are. Now, I grew up in a little town called Brighton Beach in Brooklyn, New York. Right. I lived about two blocks from the beach, and in the summertime, you know, none of the kids ever went to sleepaway camp or day camp. We used to spend the summers on the beach. That's how we spent our summers. And in Brooklyn on the beach, every few blocks on the beach, there was a different singing group from a different high school. And that's how we used to get the girls. You know, the best group got the most girls. Now, we used to sing this one song on the beach that the kids, they used to ask us to sing it over and over and over again. And we got a lot of girls singing this song. You know, I wasn't even 16 years old. In my wildest dreams, would I ever think that this song we used to sing on the beach to get the girls, 6 years later, would be a number one record in the United States of America and 36 countries all over the world and sell over 13 million records. And of course, we're talking about that song, The Jungle, you know about that one? Now, it's been in a lot of records, a lot of television shows and movies, and of course, when it was put into the movie The Lion King, RCA Victor, they re-released the record again, The Lion Sleeps Tonight, and it became a worldwide hit for the second time. And we also acquired a new audience of five-year-old kids. Now, this is the truth. When my granddaughter was 5 years old, she brought me into kindergarten for show and tell. That is the truth. So I think we have time to do, you want to hear that, Jenny? Now just because you're such a great audience, I'm going to try to sing it again in the original key that I recorded it in when I was only 9 years old.
God bless
you. Dana, give me a little F chord there, Dana. Is that the only one you have? You have any, that's the lowest one?
After that big buildup right there.
And do I say a prayer that the note comes out? Because if it doesn't work, we're all out of a job here. Don't touch me, Bill. Yeah, here we go.
Oh,
Okay, everybody standing up. You want to switch parts? You want to sing? I heard you're doing the Weema Way parts. You want to do the... Now, I know the guys could do it. I don't know about the girls. So on the count of three, you all be the lead and we'll back you up, okay? Everybody get ready. Take a deep breath. You're standing up. One, two, three, go. Oh, my God. Do it again. Come on. One, two, three.
Jay Siegel is here. You requested him. Keep doing that, because we're coming back. But right now, we're all going to sing together. Let's bring them all back. Barbara Harris, Chris Montez, Margaret Ross Williams and the Cookies, Tony Stevens and Stephanie, the Edsels, Maurice Williams and the Zodiacs, Jay Siegel's Tokens.
Goodbye, sweetheart.